Hello viewers, we hope you are enjoying your day. In this video, we are going to illustrate an unboxing process of Valor Make WR3000M Rebuck system, and then we will explain its functional process as well. So you will get this equipment in the packing you are displaying on your screen. So let's start and see what is inside this box. Let's open the box first. You will get two main boxes inside this packing. So we have taken out two boxes from the main packing unit. So first one is the main control unit. It will be carrying the WR3M main control unit, and the other box will be carrying the accessories like hot air iron, soldering iron and desoldering iron, etc. Let's open the main unit box first and keep aside the other box. So let's open the WR3M control unit box first. You will get a power cord, 230 volt AC power cord, and now we will take out the main control unit out and we will keep it on the table, and you will get the operating manual and other documentation along with this control unit and the software CD as well. So now we will open the second box, which is containing the accessories. As I told you before, the other box is containing the accessories like hot air iron, soldering iron and desoldering iron, etc. Along with this box you will get the operating manual of soldering and desoldering accessories as well. Like we are seeing that there are so many manuals which will be provided along with these accessories. So let's take out the accessories one by one. First we will take out the soldering set. See, this is the stand for soldering iron. It is basically a stop and go type stand. We will explain the connection later. Now we will just keep out the soldering iron. This is WP80 soldering iron, and now we have kept it on the its stand. Next we will take out the hot air iron, HAP 200. Now it is resting on its stand. Third one is the desoldering iron, DXV80, which we will keep on its respective support rack. See, all three stands are supplied along with the dry cleaning unit. Next is the WVP, vacuum pickup pen, which is very useful for handling small chip components. See the other accessories also, which will be supplied along with this unit. So let's start from the extreme left. This is the hot air nozzle changing tool, and the key for changing the adapter. This is the adapter which we can change with the help of this key, and there are two hot air nozzles which are also a part of the standard supply. Next, move on. This is the nozzle changing tool cum cleaning tool. So this is basically nozzle changing tool for the desoldering iron, DXV80 desoldering iron, and we can change the nozzles even in hot condition with the help of this tool, and we will explain its functional later. And there are two other nozzles which are supplied along with this desoldering iron. Next, move on. These are the filter cartridge set for TXV80 desoldering iron and the long cleaning pin for cleaning the nozzle. Next is the external filters. These are the main filters for vacuum, which we can change when the filters get older or get choked. And next is these are the air filter set for main control unit, which we can change periodically. Next is this clips for identification. These clips are used for identifying the cables when these are connected to the main unit. We can just give you an example. We have fixed a clip on both the sides of this soldering iron for identification. When it is connected to the main unit, we can easily identify the tool which is connected to the respective channel. Next is the external grounding plug. This is basically the external grounding plug which is connected on the rear side of this unit, and then it is connected to the external grounding point. Because if we are using a 2-pin main power cord, then the external grounding point is necessary, because it will provide the external grounding from the main control unit to the external grounding point. So as we are using a 2-pin plug which will be connected to the main this control unit, then we need to connect this external grounding plug which will be mounted on the rear side of this control unit. So it is mandatory to connect this to the main station and then connect it to the external grounding point when we are using a 2-pin power cord. If we are using 3-pin power cord, then this connection is not necessary, and it is not necessary to connect this external grounding point to the on the rear side of the unit. So it is preferable for Indian electrical standard condition to use a 3-pin power cord instead of 2-pin power cord. So in the next stage we will explain the process to connect and change the nozzles and then connect the respective tool to the channel as well. So let's start. We have just picked up a hot air iron HAP 200. Now we will connect the this adapter on this hot air iron, and we can also use this key to just properly connect this, fix this adapter onto this hot air iron. Then we will connect this nozzle. See, this is how with the help of this nozzle changing tool the nozzles can be attached to the hot air iron. So first thing we need to do is the just fix the adapter with the help of this key, and then pick appropriate nozzle and just use the nozzle changing tool to fix this nozzle onto this hot air iron. Then we will connect this hot air iron on the first channel. It is mandatory to connect this hot air iron to the first channel because it will not work on other two channels. So you are requested to connect this hot air iron to the first channel only, because it will sense this its wattage and then will give the maximum temperature of 550 degree on this first channel. Now next is the desoldering iron DXV80. So we will see how the nozzles can be fixed or removed from this desoldering nozzle with the help of this nozzle changing tool. See, we need to just twist the nozzle and clockwise to fix the nozzle and anti-clockwise to remove the nozzle. So this is a threadless mechanism these nozzles are using, and with the help of this nozzle changing tool we can even change these nozzles even in hot condition. Okay, so there are other nozzles supplied along with this desoldering iron which we have explained to you earlier. So next is this how to use this long pin and the cleaning tool. So we will show you. See, this long cleaning pin is used to just clean the head of this desoldering head. With the help of this long cleaning pin we can clean the desoldering head. We need to remove the nozzle from the fixture, then we can use this long cleaning pin. Next is this. Now we will again fix the desoldering nozzle and just twist it clockwise to fix the nozzle on the desoldering iron. Then see, there are different cleaning pins which are mounted on this cleaning tool. So we need to remove the aluminium cap and then just choose the appropriate pin matching the size of the nozzle, and just now we will choose the this we have this pin we have chosen. So we have fixed this aluminium cap back again. So it is mandatory to fix this aluminium cap on this cleaning tool, because if we don't just fix this cap, then this cleaning tool might burn when it is touched with the extremely hot nozzle. So you better just fix this aluminium cap back on this cleaning tool. Now we have selected the this cleaning pin, and now it is inserted inside this nozzle, but it should be inserted in hot condition, not in cold condition. So we will explain it also later on. So we can use the other cleaning pin also, matching the size of the nozzle. Now this desoldering iron is connected to the second channel. So that is how connected. Just twist this connection, and now this vacuum pipe is connected to the vacuum inlet. So we have just connected the vacuum pipe to the vacuum inlet, and similarly this hot air iron pipe is connected to the hot air inlet. So the hot air iron pipe is slightly larger than the vacuum pipe, so you can easily identify the hot air iron pipe and the vacuum pipe. So next is the soldering iron, CWPAT soldering iron. We will show you how we can change the soldering bits. Just open this barrel by rotating it clockwise, and take out the barrel along with the tip. Similarly, you can use other tip which you can buy, but these tips are optional. So next we will insert this barrel and just twist it anti-clockwise to just fix the bracket on the iron. Now this connection of this soldering iron should be connected on the rear side of this stop and go stand, which is a very unique feature, because when it is connected through this stop and go stand, whenever we will place this soldering iron on the stand, it will automatically switch off, and whenever we just lift it up, then the soldering iron will be switched on. So that we will explain you to later. Now we can see the connection once again. The wire from the stand is connected on the channel 3, and the wire of the soldering iron is connected on the rear side of this stop and go stand. So this is how the connections are made. Next we will connect this vacuum pickup pen on this control unit. See, we need to connect this inlet to this hole. It should be connected on the right side from the front view. So this is how the WVP is connected to the main control unit. In the next step we will explain the process to change the filters of main control unit. So let's remove all the accessories first and remove the vacuum and air inlet also. See, this is need to just twist this cover and just take the filter out. So we will again just twist this filter, air filter, and then take the filter out. So whenever you find that these filters are contaminated or choked, we can replace it with the new filter which are supplied along with the main unit as accessories. So filters are marked on each on like air inlet filter and vacuum filter. So these both are marked. We should use air filter for the air inlet and vacuum filter for the vacuum inlet. So it should be inserted on the arrow side on the facing the unit. So it should be connected to the first air inlet, and let's just twist it clockwise to fix the this cover once again, and then insert the vacuum cartridge. We need to just arrow should be on the side facing the control unit. Then we need to insert this vacuum inside this vacuum inlet and just twist it clockwise to fix the vacuum onto the main control unit. This is how the air and vacuum main cartridges are replaced. So whenever you find these cartridges contaminated or choked, you can replace it with the cartridge which were supplied along with the control unit as accessories. Next, in the next step we will show you how we can change the filter cartridge of this soldering iron DX. Let's see how we can change the filter cartridges of this desoldering iron. We need to just take this cover in the backward direction and just take it out. So these are the cartridge set. So whenever you find that these cartridges are full with the molten solder, or you find it this yellowish color on the rear side, you can change the filter cartridge. See, arrow should be on the side rear side. It should be pointed towards the rear side of this. See, we can, as we are explaining on this your screen, then we need to press this blue button, and then it will be fixed once again. So we can see there are few inserts supplied along with this as accessories. So we will show you its usage, how these inserts are used to connect the support rack with each other. See, we need to insert these joining and then insert on the other side of the support rack, then insert these joining rivets on the other stand, then connect it to the third support rack. So this is how these three support rack can be connected to each other with the help of these inserts. And now we can see that these three support racks has been joined to look like a single unit. Moving further, we will show the operation of all three soldering and desoldering tools. So first of all, we have connected the tools in sequence as explained before, and the vacuum pickup pen is also connected. Now let us switch on the unit. This we can, by just pressing this switch, we can switch on the unit. Now we can see that the temperature of all three tools is being displayed on the screen. You can see the arrow is showing the temperature of first channel. Next, by pressing this button, we can just move the cursor further. Now it is showing the temperature of second channel. Again pressing this button, the temperature of third channel is displayed. It is now, you know, just showing switching off, but whenever we lift this soldering iron from the stand, the temperature will start rising and the temperature of third channel will be displayed. Temperature is again decreasing because the iron is kept on the stop and go stand, and it is temperature is decreasing and slowly it will be switched off. Now we will explain how to set the temperature of individual channel. Let's start. Let's select the channel first. See, we can see the temperature we can change by pressing up and down button. There are three preset temperature of individual channel also. By selecting the 1, 2 or 3 button, we can select the desired preset temperature. If we want to change the preset temperature, then that can be done also. Suppose if we select the preset temperature of first channel by pressing 1, then by increasing or decreasing the push button, we can select the desired channel. Then long pressing this individual button, we can save the preset temperature. Earlier it was 100 degree, now we have just changed it to 130 degree. So each individual channel has three different preset temperature which we can select according to our choice. Similarly, now we will set the temperature of second channel by pressing this button. Now there are three different preset temperature of second channel also, which we can choose according to our need. So by pressing this 1, 2 or 3 preset temperature can be selected. Now we can change the individual preset temperature also for 3. Now we can see the it has now returned to the default display mode. The temperature of all three channel is displayed simultaneously. Similarly, temperature of third channel can also be selected. Now there are three different preset temperature of third channel also. We can select the default preset temperature by pressing respective button. The default preset temperature can also be changed as explained before. Now we are explaining once again. Now we will change the temperature, this default first preset temperature, to 180 degree. By long pressing this first button, the changes will be saved. Similarly, there are other buttons also, like air button. Now pressing this air button, we can increase or decrease the volume of air. 100 is the maximum level and 10 is minimum level. So the desired air volume can be selected by pressing the air button, then pressing the up or down button and selecting the desired airflow rate. Similarly, this vacuum pickup pen can be activated by pressing this pickup button on the main display, and by covering that hole on the vacuum pickup pen, the vacuum is activated, and after just removing your finger from this hole will deactivate the vacuum. So we can see that it can lift a very high weight object as well. Similarly, we can pick delicate and small SMD ICs with the help of this vacuum pickup pen. After pressing the pickup once again, the vacuum will be deactivated. The airflow can be activated by pressing this micro finger switch, which is just present on the handle of this HAP200 hot air iron. Whenever we press this micro switch, the hot air will start blowing. Whenever we remove our finger from this micro switch, hot air blow will stop. So there is a push button which sits on the desoldering iron as well. By pressing this push button, the vacuum will be activated, and by releasing it, vacuum will be deactivated after few seconds. So there is a delay of few seconds, so that the desoldering, the molten solder is properly desoldered and it is sucked inside to avoid the choking. Next, we will show you this WMRT micro desoldering tweezer, which is also a part of the supply. It is, however, optional, and the customer can buy it as an optional accessory. If we are now opening this WMRT micro desoldering tweezer, see, we will get this tweezer inside this packing. We are taking out the support rack of this micro desoldering tweezer. This is basically a stop and go type support rack for desoldering tweezer. It's one magnet is placed on the stand, which senses this micro desoldering tweezer. Whenever it is kept on the stand, this desoldering tweezer is automatically switched off, and whenever we just lift it up, it again starts operating. Now this tip set will be supplied as separate part. Now see, we need to match this polarity, left and right polarities, with this tweezer, and then insert it, then just push it to connect it properly. Yeah, you will see, you will just hear a sound. Now it is now evident that it is connected to this tweezer. Then now we will remove one accessory and connect this thermal desoldering tweezer to the main control unit, and we can select this. Now we will lift it up, and we will see that the temperature is rising. It immediately attains the set temperature. Temperature can be selected according to our choice and according to the application. And whenever just we keep it on the stand, the magnetic sensor will detect the tool, and it will automatically switch off the desoldering component. See, the width can be adjusted by pressing on both sides of this tweezer, and it is very handy tool for desoldering or soldering the SMD components, small SMD chip components. So in this video, we have explained the unboxing and working of this WR3M Revox system. It's a state of art Revox test system with the automatic tool recognition and other features as well. So hope now the concept is clear to you, and you are now ready to use this Revox station. So everything we have tried to explain. If you have any query, get back to us. Thanks for watching this video. Have a nice day.